Some people call me a Whelan shill, and I can understand why. I play into the joke, it makes sense. But I prefer being called a fan, who is also a giant critic, who follows the project, keeping people aware of the absolute disaster that is the Whelan Protocols repo and the discussions surrounding it. Stalled protocols, dead protocols, protocols that don't meet any real-world requirements but are stuck in theoretical bike-shedding hell focusing on things that don't matter. And just the other day, Joshua Ashton not only announced but put into action a project to hopefully stir up a bit of drama and get things resolved, announcing Frog Protocols for Whelan. Now, in case you forgot, Joshua Ashton is from Valve. Now, that doesn't mean this is a Valve-endorsed or a Valve-sponsored project, but there are clearly people at Valve bothered by the way that things are done in Whelan Protocols, and not just from Valve. There are a lot of people in this ecosystem that really don't like the way things are done. Let's create Whelan Protocols, but much more iterative. Whelan Protocols has long had a problem with new protocols sitting for months to years at a time for even basic functionality. We can talk about all manner of protocols, whether it's something like the screen tearing protocol, which is merged now, but sat around for multiple years before anything happened with it. Whether it's something that is still currently open, which on the GitLab says 4 years, but going back to the mailing list is actually 6 years old. Going back even further than that, the protocol is 8 years old. This is hugely problematic when some protocols implement very primitive and basic functionality, such as Frog FIFO V1, which is needed for VSync to not cause GPU starvation under Whelan, and also fix the dreaded application freezing when applications are occluded with FIFO/VSync enabled. We need to get protocols into end users' hands quicker. The main reason many users are still using X11 is because of missing functionality. Yes! 100%. You do not know how many times I've talked to people where they're like, oh, I need, I don't know, global shortcuts working, which there is a portal for it, but nothing is currently using it. So it's like a half solution, whether it's like anything, accessibility, any other number of reasons, and we can be shipping them today, but it's blocked for one reason or another. Usually it's some developer bringing up a problem that is like a theoretical problem because nobody's actually using the protocol in the real world. Nobody knows if that problem actually, you know, applies to a real use case for it. Everyone is just like bike shedding around things that might possibly happen. Now, anybody out there, and yes, I do mean anybody, can make a Whelan protocol. It is just an XML file. It'll take about, I don't know, 2 minutes to do. The real problem, though, is making the implementation. And that is exactly what Joshua Ashton has done already. Use Frog FIFO V1 protocol for FIFO. Now, I do want to talk about the replies in this thread and also to the post on Mastodon. But first, I want to talk about the philosophy of the project, like how this project is supposed to work. First things first, this project is not a competitor to Whelan Protocols. If you're building a Whelan compositor, you don't build against Frog instead of building against Whelan. This is a development space to work on protocols in an iterative manner, because whilst that should be how it functions in Whelan Protocols, that system has completely broken down and everything needs to be perfect before anything is being shipped. So, to submit a protocol, you need to have a client, so some sort of application that is going to use the protocol, a server, so a Whelan compositor that implements the protocol, and protocols need to be something that at least more than one client is going to use. So, there are a lot of things in Whelan where there are like these internal Whelan protocols that connect to some debug client or connect to some internal tool. Those are not relevant to this repo. If only you are using it, do it somewhere else. It's kind of like the AUR approach, right? Where if a package might be used by more than one person, it can be here. If it's only going to be used by you, don't do it here. Now, those rules basically apply to Whelan protocols as well, but the goal here is to be much more iterative, so we won't replace protocols whenever we need to iterate, but simply add method v2 or event V2, and keep supporting both methods or events and wrap old methods to new ones in the compositor. We'll only add a whole new protocol V2 if something is totally broken beyond repair. We will never figure this out if we don't ship it and experiment. Not every client cares about every edge case or color of the bike shed. So rather than implementing a whole new version of the protocol, if you want to update a small part of the protocol, that's totally fine. Like, you can have protocol version 1, but then method version 7 inside the protocol. As a server, if you implemented a protocol here and has been superseded by a protocol in Wayland protocols, it is still advisable to keep the Frog protocols variant implemented if possible, simply because it reduces the churn that the end users might face while clients transition. So basically, give some time for things to move over to the proper protocol rather than dropping things straight away. Makes sense. As a client, you should never expect that any protocols in this repo are available. This rule will definitely get broken, but I told you so. Definitely do not expect that for brand new protocols that might undergo rapid iterations. Definitely do not expect that in your proprietary clients. So just don't expect that these protocols are being used anywhere. This is a development space. They might be in use. They might not be in use. Make sure you check things. Now, if you've been paying attention to the channel for a while, you may recall another repo in the past, one by Probono, Wayland-X11-Compat-Protocols. Now, when this came out, I was very, very critical of it. The missing Wayland protocols for features that are available in X11 but are denied by the official Wayland protocols. The reason why I like what Joshua is doing as opposed to what was being done here is this repo just existed to complain about missing protocols, to list out protocols that are already being listed in Wayland protocols, they're just not being merged. Whereas Joshua is working on new protocols, iterating on new things, and also getting them implemented. Over here, they're expecting other people to go and implement them when they'd already been denied from Wayland protocols, so why would anybody go and implement them? Now, the response to Frog protocols has been very mixed, to say the least. There's not that many people in, like, a middle nuanced position. It's mostly very much in favor or very much against. On the very much in favor side, we have people like Neil Gomper, who has already gone ahead and made packages over on Fedora, CentOS, and also OpenSUSE Tumbleweed. And then we have Campbell Jones, who's packaged stuff over on Arch. Now, if you go look at the Frog Protocols repo, you might notice that Campbell Jones is the one who merged my pull request here. And also, in the pull request, Neil Gomper was the one who approved it. So I have a feeling, I've not spoken to either of them, that they were probably speaking to Joshua before this went public and are like coordinating things. Now, Simon Sir, the head of WL Roots, is less than a fan of this. Sad to see this instead of efforts to improve Wayland protocols, and on the Mesa merge request, he says, I don't think adding support for protocols, essentially bypassing the Wayland protocols consensus, is a good idea. The bar in Wayland protocols is not that high, and adding support for third-party protocols not representative of the Wayland community isn't a good way forward. Under that post, we have Plagman. This is Pierre-Lou Griffiths from Valve. Almost certain there's been some water cooler discussion about doing this. Like, whilst it might not be officially endorsed by Valve, there's clearly Valve people interested. And here we have a post from Xavier Hugel of KDE. Maybe more like an essay rather than a post. But this is replying to the bar in Wayland protocols is not that high. It's high enough in practice to have a lot of merge requests that are stuck for various reasons. One of the big reasons in merge requests to have an, at least initially, active author is unresolved discussions about often theoretical issues, while at the same time, some real-world problems get missed. By experimenting in the real world before committing to a stable protocol, a lot of those problems can be avoided. Also, on the note of people that Joshua probably talked to, there is an implementation in KWin by Xavier. So almost certainly Xavier was involved in that discussion as well. I know that the unstable and staging categories were meant for this purpose at some point in time, but that obviously hasn't worked at all. In my opinion, that's mostly not caused by any official requirements of merging a protocol, but by the expectation that what's merged into Wayland protocols is good enough for everyone to go implement immediately and rely on, even though it's titled unstable staging. That's literally the terms for the development version. It means it is not ready yet, people shouldn't rely on it, but it does mean it's ready enough to at least experiment with. In the color management case, we just copied a randomly tagged XML file around, and so the expectations are very different. The protocol does not have to be perfect. It does not have to handle all the edge cases. It does not have to be reviewed to no end before tagging. It just has to be useful for experimentation, and if something about it doesn't work out, it just gets replaced. The expectations of what's new in this repository are similarly much lower than what's in Wayland protocols. I don't think anyone will have an issue with doing this upstream, but I don't know how we can reduce those expectations in upstream Wayland protocols. Adding an actually experimental category will only work if the expectations match. So even if they add another category, if it's still in that same position where people just bike shed things for 4 years, nothing has changed. After everybody started noticing this project and giving their various takes, Joshua expanded upon the goals of Frog. The governance model is totally broken, referring to Wayland protocols, and needs to be just removed and should be replaced with controlled anarchy like Mesa. The fact that the repository is anything more than a collection of XML files the compositors and clients handshake on is a huge mistake. Wayland protocols should not be set up like a standards body. It doesn't deal with IP or legal frameworks like Kronos does, and the current Wayland protocols governance represents but a tiny selection of clients and compositors. This right here is the full list of projects and people with voting rights on Wayland. So every single WL Roots project is represented by these two people. It doesn't matter if it's River, Wayfire, anything else. These two people. All the projects using Western, these two people. Everything built off of QT, this one person. I can just keep going on and on. Whenever something new is proposed, the immediate reaction is typically, this goes against my ideology for what I think is pure and right for Wayland, which is totally messed up and not conducive to actually fixing problems. A great example of this is the Tearing Protocol, where the very first comment is from Simon Sir saying, Wayland is designed to be frame perfect, i.e. not have bad intermediary frames, and this protocol breaks this. It doesn't matter what your opinion is here at all. There is a real world use case for wanting screen tearing. We can talk about the EXD placement protocol and all the various iterations upon it, where even till this day, there are still Wayland developers who refuse to admit that application developers have a good reason for wanting to pick the location of a window. It is not just a technical problem. The way people treat others with differing opinions and schools of thought about how something should or could be done is really bad. And even if certain people are not directly members, they are associated / affiliated to projects who are and act incredibly hostile. Now, Joshua's not going to say the name, but I have seen the arguments that you've had with Sebastian Wick. I can say the name. People are already angry with me. It doesn't matter. In my experience, Wayland Protocols is just a lot of power tripping and useless arguing and not much actually solving problems. This is very, very, very true. As mentioned by me and others, the bar for entry for a protocol to land even in staging is ludicrously high, which leads to features taking literal half a decade to land at some times, even longer in some cases. Having a path for experimental protocols in Wayland Protocols, i.e. something that can be rapidly iterated on and implemented by clients and compositors and shipped to users, is a total must. experimental protocols can follow the basic iteration ground rules of what are defined in frog protocols to avoid there being an immense amount of churn there. But I think all of this is incompatible with the current governance model. And here we have a take from Pekka of the Western Project. The Wayland Protocol's governance model was created in the early days. People wanted lots of features in, and we fear that many of them are designed like X11 and violate the Wayland design principles, and so there was more disagreement than agreement on how to design things in order to get the features end users need. We always wanted downstream projects to develop extensions first for themselves, then see if they work for others as well. A big problem with Wayland extensions is their stability requirements are greater than those of a library ABI. If a library breaks ABI, one can at least vendor an old copy of the library with an app. That is not possible with Wayland. Protocol fragmentation hurts interoperability, which is why wide agreement on extensions is very desirable. Getting wide agreement is also the hard part of design, as everyone knows. I think in the past, at least some people have seen the acceptance to Wayland protocols as a means to force everyone to accept the extension. It does not work like that. Some extensions should get wide adoption, others do not need to. That is how the Wayland protocols namespace WP, XDG, and EXT came about. It is possible for an EXT extension to become widely supported too, but there is usually not as wide agreement initially that it would have made it into WP. Anyone can just make extensions and ship them outside of Wayland protocols. This was even an end goal in the early days when the original developer was still developing Wayland. Let downstreams mature extensions and then let them grow their support organically. I think that idea still carries, but we need to think about how to deal with the fragmentation. Wayland protocols partially came about from the desire to have blessed ground for known good extensions. And you know what? The blessed ground metaphor works really well, because only certain things are allowed to exist there, other things need to be removed. Whilst we do have this, you know, distinction of unstable, everything is treated with the same level of scrutiny, and it doesn't matter these different distinctions exist. They're all effectively the exact same thing with the way the developers approach them, and this does not seem to be conducive to actually developing protocols in an efficient manner. The fact that we're at the point we're at now is honestly impressive, but it's in spite of the system, not because of it. And I think the ultimate truth is Wayland is already naturally fracturing. We've moved past there just being GNOME, KDE, Western, and W roots. Now we have Cosmic, and Mer is more actively doing things. When Budgie ships their Wayland version, they're not going to be Mutter anymore, and they should probably join that voting committee. So we're at a point now where even something in Wayland protocols, as long as nobody knacks it, you can have something join that repo with GNOME and Western not at all being involved. Wayland is already splitting and has already split. The fact that GNOME is still a completely broken desktop and doesn't support server-side decorations already proves my point. But now what we have is a more explicit fracturing. Fracturing off some of the development into a place where people can actually work on things and actually get things merged. And yes, it is circumventing the Wayland protocols method. But the Wayland protocols method doesn't work. But the absolute best thing that can come out of this is basically forcing Wayland protocols to change what they're doing and get their act together. Wayland protocols has been getting better, removing the known bad entities, at least temporarily, and trying to clean things up. Hopefully this can be another step in the right direction and get things back on track. But let me know what you think. Do you think any of this matters? Do you think it's fine if a protocol takes 7 years to merge? Or would you like things to move at least a little bit quicker? I would love to know. So if you liked the video, go like the video. And if you really liked the video and you want to become one of these amazing people over here, check out my Patreon, subscribe to the Libero Pay link in the description down below. That's going to be it for me and... Ribbit.